let's compress this vocal. So I've already got the EQ on here, I've got this soloed, and I have one section of the vocal isolated. So I'm gonna go to the next insert point here, and I'm gonna navigate to dynamics this time. Let's load this Bomb Factory 1176. This is native to Pro Tools. So right here, this might just be confusing and overwhelming, but let's take a look at all of the different parameters here, and we'll start by looking at this meter. So however far this needle goes up the meter, that's how much gain reduction, that's how much compression is actually happening. So you can see here I have 10 decibels, and then it goes straight to 20, so it gets a little bit more extreme the further you go up the meter. So we want to set the input, which is equivalent to the threshold, so that we're ducking or compressing a tasteful amount, maybe somewhere between 5, 6, definitely under 10 dB for a vocal. So let's start by doing that and see if we can get this input knob set properly.
It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. Don't, it's not that.
So that's actually pretty good. It looks like I'm getting 6 or 7 dB of compression or reduction. Let's just adjust this and you can see what's happening as I raise or lower the input.
It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. Don't, it's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. Don't, it's not that easy.
Let's go to a different part of the song and see what's happening here.
You don't remember them, they remember you. You turn around and there they are, staring back at you, put you in your place.
So a lot less compression in this area, but that makes sense because we've got less gain, less signal.
Oh, close your eyes and see the light. Oh.
So this is a good level for it. So now we need to set the output so that we're equivalent, we're getting pretty much the same amount of signal as we were before and after. A lot of people use compression to get additional gain or volume, which is the incorrect use for this tool. We're just evening out the dynamic range. So let's go here. This is a very dynamic area. You can see there's lots of peaks and valleys. And then I'm gonna just set this output so that as I bypass it, you don't really notice a change in the volume.
It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. It's not that easy.
So it's a lot louder naturally, so we need to raise the output here.
It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice. It's not that easy, too much of a sacrifice.
I think I went a little too hot. It's a little bit louder. Like a little bit is fine. You just don't want to be using this to give yourself more volume. So once this is set, I've got about 7 below 10 dB of gain reduction with the input, and we can see that metering here. Then I'm going to raise the output level so that as I bypass this plugin, we're not getting extra volume. We're just using it to even out the dynamic range. Here's where we set the ratio. So 4:1 is a good setting for a vocal. It's subtle, it's not overly compressed. You don't want to get rid of the dynamics, you just want to manage the dynamics a bit better. So this 20:1 would be more of like a limiter situation, and we can just be here at 4:1. And that's how you're going to set the compressor for your vocal.